Another form of energy is equivalence of mass, nuclear energy. Okay. Yes. Principle of conservation of energy. Power. Let's talk about power. By principle of conservation of energy, we know that the total energy of a system remains conserved. Total energy of a system remains conserved. It just gets transformed from one form to another. Transformation takes place, but total energy will remain same. It will not happen that energy has disappeared somewhere. It gets transformed, it gets lost in the process, but total energy input is equal to total energy output. Recoverable hai nahi hai, ye baat ki baat. So that is what we call law of conservation of energy. Now, power is defined as rate of doing work. Rate of doing work. How fast the work is being done. This purely depends upon how much power is being spent. Okay. If work is carrying on slowly, less power is used. If work is done fast, then more power is used. It is, you can think like this. You have to climb these stairs, and climbing these stairs, suppose you do it by running on these stairs. So you are spending more energy to do the same work. So rate of doing work is fast. Rate of doing work is fast. So more power is being spent. Another person goes slowly. He also rises the same height. But now because he has taken more time, same work is done by the person also when he was climbing slowly. So power spent by the person is less. Okay, so power is rate of doing work. How fast you are doing work, or how fast a device or an equipment is doing work. So power is determined by rate of doing work. So power is equal to total work done in total time. Total work done in total time. So this is also called average power. And power is joule, time is second, so this is joule per second. So joule per second is given a name after the name of James Watt as a unit of power. So we call SI unit of power is watt. So watt is 1 watt is 1 joule in 1 second. When one joule of work is done in 1 second, the power spent is 1 watt. And this is 1 joule per second is watt. Okay. Now, power is delta W upon delta T. And also delta W, amount of work done, is equal to force into displacement. Force into displacement is work. If a force created a small displacement, then small amount of work delta W is done. If I replace this delta W by this, then power becomes Fx into delta x upon delta t. So what is delta x upon delta t? Delta x upon delta t is rate of change of displacement. Rate of change of displacement. And rate of change of displacement is called velocity. I can replace this by velocity. So this is fx into velocity becomes power. Since this is an instantaneous velocity, so I call it instantaneous power. Instantaneous power. So if velocity is large, power will be large. If velocity is less, power will be less. So power is defined as rate of doing work. So its unit becomes joules per second. And this joules per second is given a name in SI units as watt. 1 watt is when 1 joule of work is done in 1 second. Right? Now, amount of burden is equal to force into displacement. If we replace this work by this force into displacement, we get here force into delta x upon delta t. And this rate of change of displacement is termed as velocity. So power is also equal to force into velocity. ये इस पे numericals बन जाते हैं force into velocity पे, आपको ध्यान रखना है, ठीक है? Force into velocity gives you instantaneous power. समझ में आया बेटा ये power की बात है?
Yes sir.